You are likely to have huge file sizes when working with any website project, depending on what kind of multimedia content you are working with, whether being images, being videos, audios, and so on. It is very important for you to try as much as possible to scale the sizes of these multimedia files so that at the end, it doesn't go ahead to affect the performance or the load time of your website. So let's take a look at some few tools that I personally use to go about scaling down some of the sizes of my multimedia content before I go ahead to use them in my website project. So first of all, I'm going to start with images. So let me just minimize this. So if I'm working with images and the size of the image I'm working with in terms of dimension, in terms of the size on desk is very huge, I try as much as possible to scale it down a bit. And then because I'm using a Windows machine, I simply have the Windows tool. So I right click on the image, I go to edit, and then this opens up in Paint for me to be able to reduce the size of the image. Now, how do I go about this? I simply reduce or scale down the image size. So that's how I go about that. So once I reduce the size of this, let me just come to pixels. I probably can go ahead and reduce this to, let's say, 620 and then 411 pixels. And then it is going to reduce the size of this a bit. Now, in as much as it is reducing the size, it is also reducing it, that is the size on desk as well. But what if you don't want to go ahead to reduce the size of the image itself in terms of dimensions? I just want to go ahead to reduce the size on desk. How do you want to go about that? Now, there are tools that can help you also achieve that. So there's an online tool that you can simply use in doing that. So let me just so PNG compress. So there's pngcompress.com that allows you to compress PNG images. There's also a version of that's JPEG that also allows you to do for JPEG. So depending on the calf, that is the file format you have, you might probably also be able to search for other tools that will equally help you to do that. So it is very important to try as much as possible to keep the sizes of your images a bit low, still maintaining the quality or having the quality reduced just a bit so that at the end of the day, it doesn't go ahead to affect the performance. So this is compressed PNG, which you basically go ahead to upload the image you want to use. So let me just go ahead to demonstrate this. So let's just say this image, I say, okay, because I'm not uploading, so let me just go to the JPEG version and then I get to specify or select a JPEG image. So let me just go ahead to hit on upload. I select this. So you realize it's uploaded the image. It go ahead to, you know, compress the size of the image, and then it has reduced the, there's a quality of the image that is as well as the size. About 24%. So I'll go ahead to download this and then let me just save this. And then once I have that saved, let me just open the folder and then let me take a look at the size of this particular image on deck. So 142 kilobytes here. Let me just go to properties so we get to see it properly. So that's what we have in here. Now let's go to the original image, check the properties of it, and then this is 187. So it's taken away about 40 kilobytes from it, which I think is good, because at the end of the day, we are still trying as much as possible to improve upon the load time of the page on our website. So if we have something a bit slow and we still maintain the quality, that is good enough. So that's one way I go about compressing images, either reducing the size of the image itself in terms of dimension, because if you are shooting from a camera, you're likely to have a very huge image which you probably wouldn't need that size. So it's best for you to scale down the size in terms of the dimensions of the image, and then if the size on desk is also high, you go ahead to reduce it. Now, looking at the size, it is always important to try as much as possible to work with images or content, that is images. If you are using images, work with images, reduce the size to a maximum of about 300 or 400 kilobytes, but don't go above 500, and try as much as possible not to have your images in megabytes. That doesn't help at all, because it takes a very longer time to have those images downloaded and then display on your device you are using. So that's one way to go about compressing your images. And then another way Another tool I find very useful is this particular tool, which is iConvert Icons. Now, I have this tool installed on my system, so let me just open it up and then show you how it works. So this particular tool allows you to try as much as possible to have your images in different sizes. In terms of if you are looking at having a square, perfect square size, you can go ahead and do that. And if you are looking at having your images in different sizes, so let me just show you this. When I come to options and then I come to the advanced format, so these are the formats available. So I have icon, I have PNG, ICNS, favicon, and so on. Now the favicon allows you to create that is favicons for your project. So favicon is simply the image we have at the top in here. So if you want to create a favicon, you can go ahead and then create a favicon out of an image you place in there. So once you get to specify the sizes you want to have for a particular image, depending on what project you are working on, because there are instances where you want to have different sizes for a particular image. So if it's a PNG file, you want to maybe for the 32-bit, we want these particular sizes. And then if it's an icon, you want these sizes. So once we are certain with the sizes we want for an image, and then we are done with that over here. So we get to specify over here which particular, let me just close this instead, and then come back here. So once we have this selected, and then we bring an image in here, this is actually going to convert it to this particular image. Let's just give this a try. So I'm going to come back in here to this image, which is a JPEG. I'm going to bring it here, and it's going to ask me to select the location I want to have this image converted to. So let me just go ahead and select this. So it's actually going to change the sizes. Let me just hit on done and then come back here. And then as you can see, let me just expand this. As you can see, it didn't just change the size of the image, it tried as much as possible to compress, sorry, that is to change the file format of the image. So it was in JPEG and I now have it in PNG. So that's what this particular tool works like, or what it does. And I basically use this particular tool to work on logos. So in case I want to have different versions or that's different sizes of a logo, that's what I go about using this tool to do. And then maybe I want to have different sizes of a particular image, or I want to have a square size of a particular image, I go ahead to use this particular tool to do that. So that's how to go about using that is getting your images compressed and having them in different sizes and then so on. Now let's take a look at videos as well, because you are likely to have videos as part of your project, and how do you go about compressing it. So there's one useful tool here which is called the Handbrake. It's an open source tool, so it is free to download and use. And this tool allows you to compress your videos to a reasonable file size, trying as much as possible to maintain the quality of your video. So that's what I use this particular tool to do. And then for your audios here, you can also find tools online which is going to help you to try as much as possible to compress your audio file. So compress to compress MP3 files online. So there are sites which is going to help you to do that. So let's say this is one of the sites. This is ucompress.com. That's forward slash MP3. So this allows you to upload your file, the MP3 file, and then go ahead to compress it for you to download. In case you are not cool because it is an online service and you are looking at the privacy of your data, you could probably also look out for other tools which is going to allow you to use this particular or use the process or the procedure on your system offline to trying to achieve similar results. So mind you, it is very important to try as much as possible to have the sizes of your project files reduced so that doesn't affect the performance of your project. So just like I was saying, it is very important for you to try as much as possible to reduce the sizes of your multimedia content before you go ahead to use them or work with them in your WYSIWYG web builder website project.